On today's episode, we'll give you a bird's eye view of one of the most central parts of Canada's plan to improve our energy system and fight climate change. And we'll introduce you to an inspiring Ukrainian-Canadian innovator who's intent on making an impact with his company's ultra-fast battery charging technology.
Our mission and our goal is to enable electrical vehicles to charge as fast as it takes to fill up a tank of gas.
I'm a strong believer that, you know, when I was born, I had a certain state of the planet that I was in and the environment that was surrounding me. So that's how I'd like to return the planet back to the next generation, the same or in better state than when I got it.
Welcome to Inside Canadian Energy, where we go behind the scenes of our energy system
and shine a spotlight on the people, policies, and programs that are paving the way to a brighter future.
Hey, John.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, Dad, are we charged yet?
Even with fast chargers, most EVs take 20 to 30 minutes for the battery to get to the level you need for your trip.
Solving this issue matters because as we face the impacts of climate change, we're looking for ways to run our cars and really every aspect of our lives off cleaner energy sources.
I get it. It can feel confusing, even overwhelming, to see a path forward. But it turns out that when you zoom out and look at the big picture, the solution, while not easy, is pretty straightforward. Make almost everything electric. Why? Well, here in Canada, we're already really good at generating clean electricity. For example, if you look at a breakdown of where our energy currently comes from across every sector, only about 35% is from clean sources. But if you look at just the electricity sector, that number jumps to over 80%. That's why you're hearing so much talk about things like electric cars or electric heat pumps. The more of our lives we can shift to run off clean power like electricity, the better chance we have of cleaning up our energy system and fighting climate change.
Range anxiety with electric vehicles is a challenge to achieving this goal. However, thanks to Canadian innovators, we may soon be able to charge an electric vehicle almost as fast as it takes to fill up a car with gas. Let's take a closer look.
Meet a Canadian-Ukrainian innovator and a finalist in our Breakthrough Energy Solutions Canada initiative, Kostya Komatov. Kostya immigrated to Canada from Ukraine at age 15. His business journey started early.
So I was always very passionate about business opportunities. While I was doing my bachelor's degree at the university, and many of my classmates went, as people say, flip burgers at McDonald's, I went to flip cars overseas. So that was my first journey, kind of business relationship journey.
One day, back in 2012, one of Kostya's friends from school got fed up with how long it took to charge his cell phone.
You get a new phone, it works great. A year later, you know, starts to die really quickly during the day. My dad is really smart, so I went to him like, hey, why is this happening?
Sure, that's my guy. Like, I'm an electrical engineer.
Together with Kostya and a fourth co-founder, they started running experiments to see if they could speed up how fast the battery could charge without damaging its lifespan.
Yeah, the critical point for the company as it is right now, I'm sure, was that moment when it was necessary to test battery inside of a toaster oven.
Yeah.
I'm not sure how and why, but my wife was saying, fine, okay.
And throughout this process, because we are very good friends, you know, whenever I would come and see them and join them, and I was just fascinated by the idea because I knew that everything is going to get electric. I knew that the batteries are the future of everything. I was just having fun to be there.
We got to a point where we had some interesting test results. We decided to apply to an accelerator, Y Combinators. We ended up getting in. That's what kicked off the company, really.
Renee and I caught up with Kostya, the CEO of GBatteries.
Welcome to GBatteries. Very nice to meet you. This is where the magic happens. You can see our guys are installing batteries for long-term battery testing, battery cycling right now.
When you charge a battery, ions flow from one end of the battery to the other. That's what stores energy inside. But when you fast charge, this creates damaging chemical reactions that reduce the battery's lifespan.
The usual analogy that I bring is that if you take this room full of people and we ask everybody to run through the door all at the same time, you can imagine what's going to happen. So if we're going to break the door, we're going to crush ourselves, there's going to be chaos here, right? That's what happens inside of the battery. So that's how ions are feeling. So what we do is we kind of the bouncer at the door or an intersection light that controls that traffic. and we are aligning all of those ions or all of those people that are running through the door. So it's a smart, dynamic adoption of the charge. So charge continuously changing as it's being placed into the battery. And the outcome is we can achieve super fast rates of charge with minimal damage to the batteries.
We have successfully demonstrated an ability to ultra-fast charge electrical scooter, which we can do under 10 minutes without damaging that battery, which is very, very exciting because the uptake of two-wheelers and three-wheelers, especially in Asia, is through the roof. It's very, very popular.
Renee and I asked about the role our Breakthrough Energy Solutions Canada initiative played in his journey.
So there is a significant gap to go from the lab research to productization and commercialization of this technology. Quite significant financial investments that we do not have. So this is where NRCan, Canadian government, non-dilutive government grants, which is coming into play and enables us to take that risk, to be able to achieve and validate that technology, demonstrate it to the customers, after which they're signing licensing deals, which we are happy to say that we have a number of them already signed as one of the results of having the work with NRCan and other government programs.
We hope you've enjoyed coming along for the ride with us on this episode of Inside Canadian Energy. It's worth mentioning that as we shift more and more of our lives to be powered by clean electricity, we'll also have to generate a lot more of it. That's why we're working to scale up clean electricity generation and to improve our electricity grid.
Here at Natural Resources, we're supporting innovators like Kostya through funding initiatives like Breakthrough Energy Solutions Canada. Thanks to people like him, making the switch to zero emission vehicles and cleaner sources of energy in general is getting easier and easier.
If you have a groundbreaking idea that you want to seek some funding for,
check out the link in the description to see our open funding call opportunities.
And want to learn more about our climate and energy plan? Check out the link in the description below. And stay tuned for more info as we go
Inside Canadian Energy!
Now, we're really not ending this thing like this, are we?
Oh, come on, Dad. That's what they always do on TV.
Renee, you call me Dad one more time.